David versus Goliath is one of the best-known stories in the Bible, found in chapter 17 of the first book of Samuel. The imagery varies depending on which translation of the Old Testament you're using or the budget of the made-for-TV adaptation you're watching, but the gist is the same. Goliath is a huge giant of a warrior who challenges the Israelites to battle. They, in turn, struggle to find a champion willing to face Goliath until a little shepherd boy named David answers the call. It seems like the ultimate mismatch, but one well-placed stone flung from a simple sling ends Goliath's reign of terror. That's the basic story that everyone knows, but there's actually a lot more to the tale of David and Goliath than you usually see in the average Sunday school retelling. First, we need to talk about the elephant-sized man in the room, Goliath. Not much is actually said about Goliath in the Bible. We know that he's a champion of the Philistines, who are sort of the Decepticons to the Old Testament's Israelite Autobots. 1 Samuel 17 states that he hailed from the city-state of Gath, a region theorized to have existed in the middle of modern-day Israel. And that's more or less it. As mythological stories tend to do, this tale changed as time went on and people began embellishing it. When the story first started circulating, Goliath wasn't described as particularly massive. He's never referred to as a giant in the text, even though there are references to other giants in the Bible, like the Nephilim in Genesis. His height is given at 6 cubits in a span, or around 9.5 feet tall, but scholars have pointed out that older descriptions found in the Dead Sea Scrolls put him at just 4 cubits in a span. That's about 6'9". Still really tall, but well within the normal range for a human being. In point of fact, the Bible doesn't make a huge deal about Goliath's size at all. Samuel only brings it up once and spends more time describing what the big guy's armor and spear were made out of. And that's not the only thing the Bible fixates on more than his height. David, while chastising Israel's King Saul and his soldiers for not stabbing the Philistine champion to death, mentions twice that Goliath is uncircumcised, but never brings up his physical stature. So it sounds like the big guy should have been grateful that it was just his head that got chopped off at the end of the story. And then there's David. David continued on to become one of the most well-known characters in the Abrahamic faiths. Brought up in the Old and New Testaments, as well as the Quran, his defeat of Goliath within the context of the story had less to do with the surprise win and more to do with the righteous overcoming the unworthy. To wit, King Saul refuses to fight for his people, while a shepherd recognizes the need to kill a proverbial lion to save the metaphorical sheep. David's post-Goliath story isn't always so inspiring, though. Yes, according to legend, he went on to write the Book of Psalms, which consists of a bunch of songs and poems about how great God is. But he also got involved in some Game of Thrones-level skullduggery. After some maneuvering to secure the throne, King David goes full villain. Peeping on the beautiful Bathsheba while she bathes, David decides he has to have her, even though she is married to one of David's loyal soldiers, Uriah the Hittite. After issuing her a royal summons, David impregnated Bathsheba and then quickly tried to cover it up by having her husband brought home, with the idea that if they slept together, Uriah would assume the kid was his.
The king does what he must. His needs are the kingdom's.
Not all of them.
Uriah, however, refused to return home, basically stating that it wouldn't feel right to be with his family while all his fellow soldiers were still suffering in the field. So David instead ordered him to the front lines, secretly pulling strings to make sure that Uriah would be killed in battle. Sure enough, he was. And David immediately married the newly widowed Bathsheba. Sure, David versus Goliath is a famous underdog story of triumph over all odds. But unfortunately for David, his story didn't end there. As Harvey Dent famously said,
"You either die a hero, or you live long enough to see yourself become the villain."
Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more grunge videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.